this particular drill, again, it's balance. You use your environment as much as possible. Never be in the position where, well, I'm not at the gym, I don't have blah, 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 all those excuses. So you make your environment your training ground. Now, we've done this a long time. If you haven't done this before, do it with a spotter. I mean, do it with somebody that is there to catch you and things like that. This is actually concrete. This is a nice grippy concrete. So even though it looks wet, it's got a pretty good grip on it. So there's a couple of different ways of doing this. One is where we're making this initial contact. We're up here and then we do a push motion. Now the push is one where I can go here, I can go here, and I cannot push or control with the other hand. Meaning if I'm going here, I can't go like that with the other one. It's only the lead hand. We have to stay balanced. We can't come off the log. If we can stay in one spot without moving, that's even better. Again, that's more of a challenge for us. And if you're on the balls of your feet, that's even more dynamic. And then one person will say go, and then we just go. And the other hand
immediately
can't,
went.
The other hand can't come into play.
Go.
And so faking a person out is also okay. Pretending to go here, that commits them to an action for counterbalancing, and you fake them. So another phase of this, another thing to do, is grabbing. Not grabbing per se with the thumb involved, we're talking about hooking. But you can hook on the arm like that, pull and release. It's pull and pull and release, that sort of thing. If I can do it from the inside here, I can do it from the outside here. I can do it from the back, see? We're gonna add the hooks to the pushes, but they're all intermittent. They're all, so I'm not gonna continue forcing and pushing like this, and I'm not gonna continue grabbing and grabbing like this. Try not to get your thumb involved on the hook. It's a couple of hints, because you wanna get used to doing things that are doing in a fast punching style, that type of mentality. We wanna get our hair trigger responses, not only for our hand-eye coordination, for where we're targeting, where we're wanting to go, but also that we get the hand back fast. So if you think about your other opponent as a hot plate, or you know, fire, just plain fire. So you want to touch it and release it. And the same thing on the grabs. You touch it and you release it. That way you get used to faster timing. You get used to better location for where your hands are going.
Go.
Good. Because some of those may not be opportune time for me to actually strike. So I want to get the hand back into play when necessary. So I'm going through there, but she had changed her position, so I could no longer get a good straight line shot on that. So it would have been a waste of energy putting out. So I'd get the hand back for cover, that sort of thing. So use that mentality when you're doing this, and it's going to ramp up your training in your boxing and sparring, things like that. Next level up. 1 foot.
Go.
If you're not having fun doing this stuff either, then you're not just really enjoying life, so.
I'm waiting for both players to get balance. Like a... Go.
Ooh. Straight back worked well. Go.
Go. Go.
Fake high. Okay, this can also be done if you don't have something like this to play on in your environment. You can take your Muay Thai pads, you can balance on that. You can take a shield, you can take anything else. Yoga blocks are awesome for this, and they're cheap, and they're really something that you can carry just about anywhere. And you can do this just balancing on the ground. There's no excuse for not engaging this type of activity, which will be joyful, but it will also engage those attributes and those elements for survival. And if you can do it in a fun way, all of a sudden this stuff comes into play during that hard-hitting stuff just automatically, and that's what you want. Okay?